history book, Earthquake. Today's topic, distribution of earthquake. The earthquakes has a definite pattern of distribution. There are three major belts in the world in which the earthquake frequently occur. These earthquake belts are, number one, the circumspecific belt, that is the convergent plate boundaries. Number two, the mid-Atlantic belt, that is the divergent plate boundaries. Number three, the mid-continental belt. Number four, interplate seismicity. Number one, the circumspecific belt. The widespread and intensity earthquake activity occurs along the subduction zones at convergent plate boundaries. The circumspecific belt extends in the west from Alaska to Kuril, Japan, Mariana and the Philippine trenches beyond it, which is divided into two branches, one going towards the Indonesian trench and the other towards the Kermamek Tonga trench to the northwest of New Zealand. On the eastern side of the Pacific, the earthquake zone follows the west coast of North America and continues southwards along Peru and Chile trench on the west coast of South America. Most of these earthquakes have their focus more than 25 km deep. About 66% of the total earthquakes of the world are recorded in this belt. Number 2. The Mid-Atlantic Belt. This belt of earthquake extends along the mid-oceanic ridge and several islands near the ridges of the Atlantic Ocean. The slip floor spreading is the main cause of the earthquake in this belt. Earthquakes of moderate to mild intensity with shallow focus are recorded in this belt. The Rift Valley of East Africa and Red Sea are considered as an extension of this belt. Number 3. The Mid-Continental Belt. This earthquake belt extends along the Alpine mountain system of Europe, North America, through Asia Minor, Caucasia, Iran, Afghanistan and Pakistan to the Himalayan mountain system, including Tibet, the Pamir, Tian Shan, Altai and the mountains of China, Myanmar and eastern Siberia. This zone is characterized by larger earthquake of shallow origin and some of intermediate origin. Deep focus earthquakes are almost absent in this belt. About 21% of the total earthquakes are recorded in this belt. Interplate seismicity. Although most of the Earth's seismicity occurs along the plate boundary, the continental platforms also experience infrequent and scattered shallow focus earthquakes. The zone of earthquakes in East Africa, the Western United States and the Peninsula India are most striking. They are probably associated with incomplete rifting. Earthquakes in India. As stated in preceding paragraph, most of the earthquakes in India occur in the Himalayan mountain belt. This is a region of marked instability and is characterized by several thrust plains. The northwestern corner of the Himalayas are particularly vulnerable as there are sharp changes in strikes and the rocks are great stress. The Indo-Gangetic alluvial tract is mostly affected by the earthquake originating in the Himalayan belt, but changes appear to be still taking place at the bottom of the Gangetic trough, giving rise to the occasional earthquake. The major earthquakes that occurred in the subcontinent of India during the last about 200 years may be observed from the data that the catastrophic earthquake in India occurred in the northeast India, Indo-Gangetic plain, the Himalayan and the Run of Kutch. Based on the intensities of earthquake recorded, the Indian Standard Institution and the Meteorological Department have published a map of India showing seismic zones. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.